the biggest issues for Queensland Rugby League at the moment?
Winning Origin in the next few months. That's the main priority. We've got two great teams, one coming off a victory last year, the men's team. The women's team gets two opportunities this year to beat New South Wales. So I think anyone that's had anything to do with Billy gets the sense pretty quick that he's a very sharp mind. He's taken to the Origin coaching role very quickly, had success in his first series. He comes out of a great system under a great coach in Craig Bellamy. And we're very confident that he's going to be better again this year, as will the team. And so once this series is done, in consultation with the board, we'll move into negotiations with Bill and then hope that he's as keen as we are to continue the partnership. But that's always the case with every coach that tends to take the reins for Queensland, particularly those that have been in clubland and still have ambitions to potentially be an NRL head coach. But that'll all form part of the negotiation. We want Billy to stay. We've got to convince him that that's the right path for him in the short term. And if at some point on that journey he develops ambitions to go and coach in the NRL, as we have done previously, then we'll do our best to support those ambitions.
Have you got a plan B?
At the moment, you'd have to think it was Josh Hannay. He's been an interim coach in the NRL. He's been great support. I think Billy's openly credited his involvement. And then, Matt Ballin's a senior assistant at the Brisbane Broncos. And then we've got the two old fellas who sit in the background, Wayne Bennett and Mel Meninga, are also ready to pick up the slack if there's a gap. But that's been a discussion more recently at the board level, which will find its way into my world, about how we shore up those candidates so that succession planning around that very important role is well and truly taken care of.
Why did you leave and how hard was it to leave?
It was difficult, but I guess between myself, the head coach and the CEO, so Kevy and Dave, we were constantly in conversations about how we were going to get the program into shape, from when we all came together in 2021. To give the players the experience that they needed to be the best that they could. And at the centre of that sat the roster management component. And there'd been a whole lot of good work done over the 2 years. I mean, when Kevy took over, the Broncos were coming off a wooden spoon. And, they sit in the top four at the moment, and only a week or so ago were on top of the table. So there's been a whole lot of good work done. This role came along, and both Dave and Kevy knew that I had a deep passion for the QRL. And my first instinct was to stick, but in more conversations with Kevy and Dave, I felt comfortable that they were comfortable I could pursue this role. So we leave on great terms. Kevy and I have got a long relationship. We won a premiership together in 2000. Dave was great to work with and for. So I guess I feel good in knowing that the Broncos were in a better spot than when we all arrived there back in 2021. We challenged each other, absolutely. And I've got no doubt that because we weren't prepared to operate in an echo chamber where there were some really honest conversations about what needed to happen, that's a big reason why the Broncos are where they are now. But we were able to delineate between work and Tognini's Cafe, where we met most mornings. Personal conversations were personal conversations. When we got to work, our job was to challenge each other. Because if you don't do that, if you don't push the boundaries, if you don't have honest, robust debate, then you keep doing what you've always been doing. And that wasn't good enough for the Bronx. And so Kevy and I remain great friends. Again, I saw him this morning at the local cafe. He wished me all the best. And I think we'd all admit that the Broncos of 2023, under his guidance and leadership, are in a really good spot.
Pretty exciting coming in after the Dolphins have started as well. Now there's talk of Brizzy Tigers or a Cairns-based Pacifica team. What do you make of those two ideas?
Look, what have we had? The Gold Coast Titans, now the Redcliffe Dolphins. Queensland seems to be the place to expand the game. Of course, the Brisbane Tigers, formerly the East Tigers, have a long history in this jurisdiction. The QRL are right in behind their bid to be the 18th franchise. And on top of that, knowing that this Pacifica element, which I think would probably be born primarily out of PNG, this organisation is proud about the work that we've done, you know, with the PNG Hunters, and starting to put down real roots in a country that loves rugby league. In fact, it's its number one code, to the point where they believe they're ready to take the step up. There'd be a whole lot of things would have to be modelled to understand how it could work. And then, look, if there's some way that you could engage and embrace at that level the Pacific element of our game, I think that would be wonderful. But if we're in a rush and we're trying to get to 18 teams quick, then I think the logical solution to that is the Brisbane Tigers bid. Based on what I know, they are very keen to push out through that Western Corridor, which has been very important to this organisation. So Ipswich Jets have been a great brand in Queensland for a long time. The Clydesdales have come and gone a couple of times, but we are back in Toowoomba under the Western Clydesdales brand. So if the Brisbane Tigers were elevated to the NRL and they were to affiliate out through that region, I think that would be a good thing for the game. The statewide footprint, in fact, it goes across two states and two countries that we've established over the last 27 years, is the envy of every code in this country and possibly around the world. And so I'm happy to work with the board to look at whatever is proposed, because our NRL clubs who are based here in Queensland are important stakeholders to us. But if that statewide footprint is diminished in any way, then we're going to make some noise. So I haven't seen all the details yet. I've been involved on the other side, having worked for the Brisbane Broncos, and that's a club that has three affiliates. I sort of understand the Cowboys' position, haven't spoken in depth to the Titans. But if the ARLC are committed to bush footy and pathways outside of metropolitan areas, then there is no better model than what currently operates under the QRL in our Host Plus Cup and BMD Premiership. I don't know, I read a stat through the week that last year's State of Origin team, that the men's team in game one, had played a total together of 394 Queensland Cup games. You know, last year's Dally M medalist, Nicho Hynes, was cast out of the NRL, spent 2 years at the Mackay Cutters. That's how he found his way back in to be the player that we all admire today. You know, he took to Cooper Cronk and Billy Slater and Cameron Smith. So National Reserve grade would diminish that significantly. So from our perspective, it's never been on the table. It's a silly idea. It should not be entertained. And so we're going to work through this next idea that's been tabled, that our NRL clubs in Queensland, Cowboys and Titans, are looking at a reserve grade side. And as we get in more information and understand the impact it will have, then the QRL will be able to formulate a strong position on it.